Joining me now from Southern California, founder of Stop the Poop, Baron Partlow. Baron, halfway through the year, the number I heard is that the beaches have been closed in Imperial Beach 50 times. We're about halfway through the year, as I mentioned. I went to a state university. It takes me a little while to do the math, but that tells me about a quarter of the time this year, beaches have been closed.
Graham, on the south end of Imperial Beach, from South Seacoast Drive to the Mexican border, which is about 2 miles, the beach was closed every single day until 2 weeks ago. And these recent sewage spills, the last couple of weeks, total 5.7 million gallons with no rain event through the river, which usually drives these sewage flows.
This latest event, this latest spill, was no small spill. You just gave the total, but this latest one that happened within the last 48 hours in the neighborhood of 3.5 million gallons, and a week earlier it was 1.8 million. The International Boundary and Water Commission is supposedly, ostensibly involved in trying to mitigate all this. They're the ones, in fact, that send you the updates on these spills, thanks to them. But what are they doing about it? How are they trying to address this problem?
Well, I'm actually a member of the Citizens Forum Board of the United States International Boundary and Water Commission. I didn't just form an activist group and run my mouth anymore. I had to get involved into the solutions. And IBWC, like I've told you before, Graham, they meet their contractual obligation at the border by treating and pumping 25 million gallons a day off of Mexico. Now, in February of 2017, we had 17 days of flow from a collector break in Mexico that they were working on, and we had a 100-year storm that brought all that sewage along with it. But this latest one of 3.5 million gallons within the last 48 hours was also on a 60-inch collector line Mexico was working on, and it ruptured while they were working on it. Didn't they learn anything from before? Put the resources in place to prevent an accident from happening that might happened that has already happened? How could they make that mistake? I wouldn't make that mistake.
There are multiple sources of the sewage, right?
Yes,
and we've identified that. There are several, but they're all coming from Mexico. Unfinished concrete flood channels, which is a bi-national problem. The runoff from TJ, just in general. And then there's an antiquated Mexican sewage facility, which is, you know, as the crow flies, is probably, what, about 5 miles south of Imperial Beach. But the bottom line is, if these three things were addressed, for example, if that old sewage facility in Mexico was updated, maybe even using U.S. tax dollars, if those flood channels were finished, this would help with the problem, correct?
You definitely upgrade the Punta Las Banderas treatment plant to secondary treatment, and you wouldn't even probably have to go as far as secondary treatment if you just upgraded it and let it pump out at advanced primary treatment. There's a pump station right at the border on the Mexican side called Pump Station Silla. If you doubled or tripled that capacity, what you could do is you could run pumps, and as you cycle them for maintenance, run the backup redundant system. And that's not happening right now there. And like you said, these concrete flood channels, it's so much easier to control flows and build infrastructure off of concrete.
And there's also a South Bay sewage treatment plant, which is on the U.S. side of the border, which was built to help mitigate this problem. It has, but it's not being used to capacity. And so you have two members of Congress who kind of share this area. It's the 52nd and the 51st districts of Scott Pelosi-Peters in the 52nd and Representative Juan Vargas of the 51st. How are they helping you, Baron?
Well, Congressman Juan Vargas, my congressman in the 51st Congressional District, will stand at the border while President Trump is in town, telling him, President Trump, you're not welcome in California. He's not representing us to our president in Washington. Why does it take the mayor of San Diego, a mayor, to go to Washington, be summoned by Trump while he's there, not visit him on his own volition, be summoned by Trump? But these guys will go visit the Mexican president and they won't engage the American president? Why does it take a mayor to go talk to the president when we have senators and congressmen in Washington who could do just that? They're doing a poor job, Graham.
And Juan Vargas saying that the President Trump is not welcome in San Diego County, but apparently the sewage from Mexico is. You need President Trump's help on this one. You agree?
He's the ultimate champion of the people. President Trump is not only an advocate of American people, he's a businessman. He knows a sound business investment enforcement when he sees it. And he knows that these guys have been on the job for so long and let it get so bad and go from bad to worse that they are a bad investment. And that if he invests in the American people who have the sound solutions that are only pennies on the dollar that these guys are asking hundreds of millions of dollars for, then he'll back us.
It's not unlike the assault, the human assault that's going on the border with illegal immigrants. This is just another form of assault. And in this case, it happens to be sewage from Mexico instead of illegals from Mexico. Baron, good luck. Keep in touch.
Thank you, Graham.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.